do a little monologue called The Green Eye of the Little Yellow God. Now, as you know, this is a story of the British Army in India in the 1800s. And it is a story of a young lieutenant who was a bit of a happy-go-lucky sort of chap. And he was in love with the colonel's daughter. And it was her birthday. And he asked her what she would like for a birthday, where the natives used to worship this little golden image, and it had a beautiful green emerald in the middle of his forehead to act as an eye. And just for a joke, she told him that she would like the eye of the god for a birthday present, but only as a joke. And he didn't take it as a joke. And this is the story of how the young lieutenant went and stole the green eye of the little yellow god. There's a green-eyed yellow idol to the north of Kathmandu. There's a little marble cross below the town, where a broken-hearted woman tends the grave of Mad Karu, and the little yellow god forever gazes down. He was known as Mad Karu to the subs of Kathmandu. He was hotter than they felt inclined to tell. But for all his foolish pranks, he was worshipped in the ranks, and the colonel's daughter smiled on him as well. He had loved her all along with a passion of the strong, and the fact that she loved him was plain to all. She was nearing 21, and arrangements had begun to celebrate her birthday with a ball. Mad Karu asked what she would like. They met next day as he dismissed his squad, and jokingly she told him that nothing else would do but the green eye of the little yellow god. On the night before the dance, Mad Karu was in a trance. They laughed at him as they puffed at their cigars. But for once, he didn't smile, he just sat alone a while. Then he walked out in the night beneath the stars. He returned before the dawn with his shirt and tunic torn, and a big gash across his forehead, dripping red. They patched him right away, and he slept right through the day. And the colonel's daughter sat beside his bed. He woke, and he asked for his tunic to be brought. She brought it, and he thanked her with a nod. He asked her to search his pockets, saying, "That's from Mad Karu. 'Twas the green eye of the little yellow god." She upbraided Mad Karu in the way all women do, and her eyes were strangely hot and wet. She refused to take the stone and left him there alone with the jewel that he had chanced his life to get. When the ball was at its height on that still and tropic night, she thought of him and hastened to his room. And as she crossed the barrack square, she could hear the dreamy air of a waltz tune softly stealing through the gloom. His door was open wide, silvery moonlight shining through. But the floor was wet and sticky where she'd crossed. Ugly knife was buried in the heart of Mad Karu. 'Twas the vengeance of the little yellow god. Now And there's a green-eyed yellow idol to the north of Kathmandu. And there's a little marble